Oldham and Ken Olomi from Salford are all here to play 15 to 1, presented by William G. Stewart.
Thank you. Hello. Our previous winner today is Dennis Spivey from Barnard Castle in County Durham. Welcome back, Dennis. Just halfway through the series, the finals board is looking pretty competitive. And yesterday's winner, David Albinson, who's made it to three grand finals in the past, will be lucky to survive this time. But for today, Jenny Scott is the target. Off we go. And we begin with Mark Zaccarini from West Yorkshire. Mark, sport. Which Asian city has been awarded the 2008 Summer Olympic Games?
Beijing.
And Mike, please, theatre. Which theatre, opera and film director founded the Royal Shakespeare Company in 1960? Sir Peter Hall. Bill, please. Since the Norman Conquest, only five monarchs of England or Great Britain have been buried abroad. Who is the only one to have been buried in Germany? George I. And Malcolm, please. Space travel. The name, please, of the spacecraft in which Yuri Gagarin orbited the Earth in 1961?
Vostok.
Yes, Vostok 1. And Daphne, please. Television and the news. In July, Channel 4 screened the Fly on the Wall documentary, Amanda Platel's Secret Diary. It was a behind-the-scenes look at whose campaign during the general election?
I don't know.
William Hague's. She was the Conservative Party's communications director. Paul, who was the Greek winged goddess of victory whose name now appears on running shoes all over the world?
Nike.
And Brian, on the same subject, who was Nike's Roman equivalent?
Athena.
Victoria. Leela, please. Food and drink. In the United States, what's the main ingredient of the popular dish called hash browns?
Potatoes.
Dennis, please. Music and the 1950s. The American disc jockey Alan Freed is credited with coining which popular three-word term for a type of pop music?
Rock and roll.
And Julian, please. Classical architecture. What name is given to the draped female figure which acts as a supporting column? Caryatid. The Old Testament, Neil. When preparing to fight the giant Goliath, how many stones did the boy David choose for his sling, although he only used one?
Six.
Five. Michael, please. Which Shakespeare play begins Act One, Scene One, Venice, a street? Enter Rodrigo and Iago. Othello. Chris, please, the honours list. The name, please, of the actress who found early fame on television in Upstairs, Downstairs, played the title role in the film Shirley Valentine and received the OBE this year. Pauline Collins. Mike, the 20th century in the United States. Warren Harding and Calvin Coolidge served as president. The St. Valentine's Day massacre took place. Wall Street crashed. All in which decade of the 20th century?
The 1920s.
Ken, please. Geography. Gotland, the largest island in the Baltic Sea, is a province of which European country?
Turkey.
Sweden. And, Mark, your second question. What job specifically connects the three names Piers Morgan, Paul Dacre and Chris Williams?
Newspaper editors.
They are. The Mirror, the Daily Mail and the Express. Mike, please. Still newspapers. Rebecca Wade, at the age of 33, is the youngest editor of a national newspaper. Of which Sunday newspaper is she the editor?
Sunday Times.
News of the World. Bill, please. Rugby Union. Which Leicester and England lock forward made history this year by becoming the first player to captain two Lions tours?
Martin Johnson.
Malcolm, please. History of Scotland. Which city was the capital of Scotland until the middle of the 15th century?
Aberdeen.
Perth. Daphne, please. Science and chemical elements. The Latin name for which element is natrium, hence its symbol Na? Sodium. Paul, what name connects the Alpine Pass linking Brig in Switzerland with Isella in Italy and a tunnel to the northeast that is one of the longest rail tunnels in the world? Simplon, the Simplon Pass and the Simplon Tunnel. Brian, British Prime Ministers. Who is the only 20th century Prime Minister to have won three successive general elections?
Margaret Thatcher.
And Leela, please. Football. Which player famously burst into tears during England's 1990 World Cup semi-final defeat against West Germany because he had been booked and, had England won, would have missed the final?
Paul Gascoigne.
Dennis, please. What name, derived from the Latin for tin, was given to the tin mining district in Cornwall and Devon?
The Stannaries.
Yes, indeed. And Julian, please. Children's books. The Misters Tickle, Bump, Happy, Greedy, Nosy and Topsy-Turvy feature in the Mr. Men books, created by whom?
Yes, sir.
Roger Hargreaves. Neil, please. Phobias. A person with algophobia, spelt A-L-G-O, algophobia, has a morbid fear of what?
The sea.
Pain. Michael, please. Liberty Enlightening the World is the formal title of which world-famous monument?
The Statue of Liberty.
And Chris, please. The 16th century. The massacre of French Protestants on the 24th of August 1572 is known by the Saint's Day on which it occurred. Which saint?
Bernadette.
Saint Bartholomew. And Mike, please. Which Hebrew word meaning fit, pure or proper is used to refer to food that conforms to Jewish law?
Kosher.
And Ken, fruit. Which fruit, a berry that may be green, red or blue-black, is produced from the plants of the genus Vitis or Vitus?
Juniper.
Grapes. Six down, nine to go, and those six must leave us now, ladies and gentlemen. And Philip, please.
And those eliminated are Mike Stevens, Daphne Smith, Julian French, Neil Massey, Chris Watts and Ken Alomi. And of the remaining nine contestants, four still have their three lives intact.
We start round two with Mark at number one, the first correct answer, and we can start nominating. And we start with the BBC's political editor. Mark, between 1981 and 1992, published his first novel, A Clouded Peace, this year. His name, please.
John Simpson.
John Cole. Bill, please. Horse racing. Which prestigious festival takes place annually in Gloucestershire in March, although it was cancelled this year due to foot and mouth?
Cheltenham.
And number, please, Bill.
Number six.
Law, Paul. What word from the Latin for elsewhere is used for the assertion by an accused person that at the time of the offence with which he is charged, he was somewhere else? Alibi. Again, please, Bill.
Number four.
And Malcolm, please. Pressure groups, radio and television. The independent pressure group whose chairman is Jocelyn Hay is abbreviated as VLV. What does VLV stand for?
Yours,
No, it's the voice of the listener and viewer. Again, please, Bill.
Number 12.
And Michael, please. From the Latin for goddess, what name is given to a great female singer, especially in opera?
A diva.
And a number, please, Michael.
Number seven.
And ballet, please, Brian. Which ballet, composed by Delibes, features a doll maker, a lifelike doll, and the lovers, Swanilda and France?
Pinocchio.
Coppelia. Again, please.
Number six.
The USA, please, Paul. Salem, the scene of the 17th century witch trials, and Plymouth, landing site of the Mayflower, are in which state?
Massachusetts.
And a number, please.
14.
Mike, please. Tarzan Gets Back Into the Swing is how one Sunday newspaper referred to which businessman and former Member of Parliament this year? He is the founding chairman of the publishing house Haymarket.
Michael Heseltine.
Heseltine. And a number, please, Mike.
Eight.
The royal family, Leela. Having married a member of the royal family in 1978, by what title is the Baroness Marie Christine von Reibnitz now known?
Princess Michael of Kent.
Yes. And a number, please.
One.
Still the royal family, Mark. Which royal residence in London takes its name from the third son of George III, who later became William IV?
Pass.
Clarence House. He was the Duke of Clarence. Again, please, Leela.
Three.
And Bill, please. Wales. Penfro, P-E-N-F-R-O, is the Welsh name for which town in the southwest corner of Wales from where ferries depart for Rosslea in Ireland?
Fishguard.
Pembroke. Again, please.
14.
And Mike, please. History of Scotland. Which Scottish soldier who became a national hero after his resistance to English rule at the turn of the 13th into the 14th centuries was played by Mel Gibson in the film Braveheart?
William Wallace.
And number, please, Mike?
9.
Literature and films, Dennis. The films The Ministry of Fear, Orient Express and The Confidential Agent are all adaptations of works by which British novelist?
Graham Greene.
And number, please, Dennis?
Number 4, please.
And Malcolm, the Bible, the Book of Exodus. Which was the first of the 10 plagues sent by God to Egypt?
Locusts.
The Nile turning to blood and the fish all dying. Again, Dennis?
Number 1.
And the Bible again, Mark. The Authorised Version, Matthew. Beware of false prophets which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are, I want the next two words.
Pass.
Ravening wolves. Again, please, Dennis?
Number 8.
Leela, in 1947, a medical man from Munich began producing a type of footwear with air-cushioned soles which still bears his name today. What are they called?
Dr. Scholes.
Doc Martens. And again, please?
Number 14.
And Mike, please. What in Suffolk, the county of Suffolk, are Waveney, Orwell, Devon and Stour?
Rivers.
Yes, they are rivers. And onwards, please.
Number 6, please.
And Paul, he died in 1950. According to the Guinness Book of World Records, he was the world's oldest dramatist. He wrote the plays Buoyant Billions and Why She Would Not when in his 90s. Who?
George Bernard Shaw.
And a number, please, Paul?
9, please.
Dennis Charles Dickens. Which Dickens novel opens at the Maypole Inn in 1775, 5 years before the Gordon riots?
Barnaby Rudge.
A number, please, Dennis?
14.
And Mike, please. What's the English equivalent or translation of the Latin proverb divide et impera? Divide et impera.
To the emperor his own.
Divide and rule. Again, please.
Number 3, please.
Bill, please. Popular music. Which surname links the American musicians Freddie, BB and Albert, leaders in the blues movement in the 1960s?
King.
And a number, please, Bill.
Number 7.
Brian, the name of which Kent coastal town was summarised by Oscar Wilde as the nom de plume of Ramsgate?
Margaret.
Yes! Oh, I don't often do this, but I was actually willing you to get it. Right, let's get on with this game. A number, please.
12.
And Michael, please. The Commonwealth, which city is the administrative capital of South Africa?
Is it Pretoria?
Yes, it is. A number, please?
Number 3.
And Bill, in which English county are Brooklands Museum, the Royal Horticultural Society's gardens at Wisley and Epsom Racecourse?
Sorry.
A number, please, Bill?
Number 6.
And we're back to Shakespeare, Paul. The Twins, Everybody Mistaken and See If You Like It, all stage adaptations of which Shakespeare play?
Merchant of Venice.
A Comedy of Errors. Again, please, Bill?
Number 7.
The Middle East, Brian. What's the name of the hilly area overlooking the Jordan Valley that was annexed by Israel in 1981? The Golan Heights. Yeah. Again, please, Bill.
Number 8.
And Leela, Scotland and famous Scots. Born in Dunfermline, he made his fortune from iron and steel in America. He spent much of his wealth on benefactions and a concert hall in Manhattan is named after him. Who was he?
Sir Andrew Carnegie.
Yes, or Carnegie. And onwards, please. A number?
12.
Michael, please. Mathematics. The interior angles of a quadrilateral add up to 360 degrees. How many degrees do the interior angles of a pentagon add up to?
540.
A number, please?
Number 3.
Bill, in which opera by Prokofiev does the son of the king suffer from melancholia and will die unless he is made to laugh?
Peter and the Wolf.
The Love for Three Oranges. Again, please, Michael.
Number 8.
Leela, please. Waiting for Godot, Endgame and Crap's Last Tape. Works by which Irish playwright and novelist awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1969? Samuel Beckett.
Yes.
Again, Michael.
Number 8.
And again, Leela. In this so-called scramble from 1880 to 1902, which continent was almost completely annexed by the European powers?
Africa.
A number, please, Leela.
14.
Mike, please. Still Africa. Of which African country was Hastings Banda the first president?
Tanzania.
Malawi. Again, Leela.
12.
Michael, please. Entrepreneurs, the Japanese businessmen Masaru Ibuka and Akio Morita founded which famous electronics company?
Sony.
And a number, please.
Number 14.
Mike, please. English law. What is the correct legal term for someone who commits a contempt of court?
Contemptor.
Contemnor. There you are. It is 12 down, 3 to go, and after the break, Leela Martin from Chester, Dennis Spybe from Barnard Castle in County Durham, and Michael Crampsey from Glasgow will be here for the final. Do please stay with us.
How confident are you to wash danger whites like these? Let's find out.
Hello.
Princess. I've got one that says queen. But do you think it'll be a royal pain to wash?
It could be with the darker colours on the white.
It's a challenge for new dads with Dialog Plus. Here on Kaylee's luxury bed.
I'm really, really impressed. Kaylee's very fussy with what she wears.
I'm not that fussy.
If it's not as white as white, if it's a dingy blue, she won't wear it.
Still a princess?
Yes.
New dads with Dialog Plus helps even danger whites stay brilliant white. You look good in a horse.
It's worse than we thought. You'll have to use the probe. Now go under the rim. Weeks of dirt and grime. You'll need new Harpic Power Foam, our amazing new cleaning system. First it clings, then expands, so you can clean the rim and the whole toilet effortlessly.
New Harpic Power Foam, expert cleaning power.
And now, to tackle the buildup of lime scale in those inaccessible areas below the waterline, Harpic brings you new power tablets, eliminating lime scale completely. Harpic, expert cleaning power.
Catch a falling
Perry
star
Como, Gold, the greatest hits from the world's best love crooner.
And I love you so.
25 solid gold classics, including And I Love You So, Magic Moments, Catch a Falling Star, and the beautiful It's Impossible.
It's just impossible.
The king of easy listening is back. Perry Como, Gold, the greatest hits, out now on CD.
Three surviving contestants in today's 15-1 final are Leela Martin, a retired civil servant from Chester, Dennis Spybe, a retired librarian from Barnard Castle in County Durham, and Michael Crampsey, a central heating service engineer from Glasgow.
Thank you. Welcome back. Leela, Dennis and Michael, put your fingers on the buzzers and off we go. British history. A fleet of 11 ships known as the First Fleet sailed from Portsmouth in 1787 with over 1,400 people on board on a voyage which lasted 8 months. What was its destination? Michael?
Australia. Botany
yes,
Bay, convicts,
Botany Bay it was. They were convicts. Mathematics and prime numbers. 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23. What's the next prime number? Michael?
29.
It is indeed. Science and chemistry, H2SO4, HCl, HNO3. What sort of chemical compounds are they? Michael?
Acids.
They are acids. Three correct answers. Question or nominate?
Nominate Dennis.
Dennis, famous quotations. There is no such thing as a tough child. If you parboil them first for 7 hours, they always come out tender. The words of which comedy star famed for his antipathy to children? W.C. Fields. Again, please, Michael.
Dennis, again, please.
Dennis, please. Films of 2001. In which recently released Hollywood film does the dastardly moggy Mr. Tinkles take on mankind's protector, Lou the Beagle?
102 Dalmatians.
Cats and Dogs, it's called. And Michael, again, please.
Dennis, again, please.
And still cinema, Dennis. The Jurassic Park films are based on the writings of which American author?
Michael Crichton.
Question or nominate?
Michael, please.
Michael, the Bible, the New Testament, St. John. Which miracle did Jesus perform at Siloam, a pool in Jerusalem?
The raising of the dead man.
He cured a blind man. Again, please, Dennis.
Michael.
Michael, the famous computer company IBM. What exactly, please, do the letters IBM stand for?
International Business Machines.
Add question or nominate?
Leela.
Leela, look at this, please, and tell me, American history, who is this man, a famous 19th century assassin?
Booth.
Yes, John Wilkes Booth, yes it is, the man who shot Abraham Lincoln. And question or nominate?
Nominate Dennis.
Dennis, please. Television. The machine guns could have a clear field of fire from here to Timothy White if it wasn't for that woman in the telephone box. Which television comedy featured this line in its very first episode in 1968?
Monty Python.
Dad's Army. You have to leave us. And Leela again, please. Question or nominate?
Question.
Name connections. What surname connects the American jazz singer Bessie, the English show jumper Harvey, and the Scottish political economist Adam?
Smith.
Question or nominate?
Question.
Opera. What's the German title of the opera by Richard Strauss, which translates into English as The Night of the Rose? Der Rosenkavalier.
Yeah, yes.
Fingers back on the buzzers, please, both of you. What is a Bissex-style year more commonly called? Michael?
A leap year.
It is. Question or nominate?
Nominate.
Quotations, Leela, this one from the 17th century. Which historic figure said after his arrest for plotting against Parliament, a desperate disease requires a dangerous remedy?
I didn't know.
Guy Fawkes. And again, please, Michael.
Nominate.
Australia, Leela, what's the state capital of South Australia?
Adelaide.
Question or nominate?
Question.
The ancient world, which was the chief city of ancient southern Mesopotamia, its name meaning gate of the gods?
Is it Babylon?
Question or nominate?
Question.
Sport. At what stage of a knockout tournament are the number one, number two, number three and number four seeds theoretically destined to meet?
In the semi-finals.
And question or nominate?
Question.
Still sport, the game of golf. Which American golfer has the nickname the Golden Bear?
Arnold Palmer.
Jack Nicklaus. Yes. Well, Michael, you've got a winning score so far of 52, two lives intact. There are 22 questions left, so let's take it steadily. You ready?
Yep.
In which decade of the 20th century were Britain's railways nationalised, was the Butler Education Act passed, and was the National Health Service created?
1940s.
Genetics. I need a letter of the alphabet, please. Which sex chromosome from the father means a baby will be male?
X.
The other one. Y. Motorways. Which motorway runs between Birmingham and Exeter?
It's the M5.
20th century history. Who in 1960 became the first president of independent Cyprus?
Archbishop Makarios.
Art and artists. The name, please, of the 18th century artist whose best known works include the series of paintings and engravings, A Harlot's Progress, The Rake's Progress and Marriage à la Mode.
Hogarth.
Rust proofing, this is headed. What is iron or steel coated with in the rust-proofing technique called galvanising?
Zinc.
It is. Famous composers? Mozart, Bruckner, Schubert. Their common nationality, please?
Austrian.
Measurement. Which traditional land measurement is equivalent to 4,840 square yards?
1 acre.
Will you please look at this and tell me, this brightly coloured bird of the Trochilidae family can hover, fly backwards and produce a low continuous sound by the rapid vibration of its wings. What's it called?
It's a hummingbird.
It is. American literature. The Third Life of Grange Copeland, Meridian, The Colour Purple. The American author, please.
No, I'm afraid I don't know.
Alice Walker. Well, there you are, Michael. A winning score of 132, no place on the finals board, but an invitation to come and join us sometime next year. Well done.
OK, thank you very much.
There you go. Thank you very much. Thank you. Before we go, I think I've told you that we have all the contestants we need for this series, but we'll be looking for another nearly 2,000 of you for 2002. So if you fancy your chances on the programme, here's the address to write to. 15 to 1. P.O. Box 273, London W1A6EH, and postcards only, please, or by email to 15to1@channel4.com. And a reminder that we are accepting applications from anyone, apart from previous winners, who has auditioned or appeared on the programme prior to the 31st of December 1998. And as we process applications in the order in which we receive them, the sooner we hear from you, the sooner you will hear from us. We'll be back tomorrow, same time, same place. See you then.
You're cruising in the quiz zone here on Daytime. That means Countdown is next.
One of the most inhospitable places on Earth.
Oymyakon is the coldest town in the world.
You may get frostbitten during an hour.
Okay, so minus 42, not cold. I lost communication with my toes extremely early on. My fingers are gone and my nose.
Exploring some of the toughest places on Earth. Nick Middleton is going to extremes, starting with cold, Sunday at 8 on 4.
Whoa, mister, wait a minute! Whoa!
These days, everyone's after digital TV, aren't they?
Well, call NTL now, and like me, you can get your favourite channels, such as Sky Sports, Discovery and ITV2, without addition sight.
You can also visit websites, send and receive emails via your telly, without being charged.
And because NTL includes a phone service, you get loads more for your money. Catch the best in digital TV, without the dish.
Call free on 0500 500 400 to see if NTL Home is available in your area.
More than 1,000 women lost their husbands. Scores of countries lost at least one person. September 11th was the day the world changed. Today we all feel vulnerable. We don't know what is in the mind of our enemy, or where or how he will strike next. Channel 4 asks, could this be a war without end?
Follow New York City firefighters as they cope with the aftermath of the September 11th attacks. The War Without End series continues with Heroes of Ground Zero, Thursday at 9 on 4.
Faking It is back. Can a fast food vendor become a top gourmet chef in only 4 weeks? Or is it the ingredients for a disaster? Take one, Burger Man. Add David Larris, head chef at one of London's top restaurants.
Donkey.
Then pulverise the poor guy's feelings to pulp with Gordon Ramsay. Smile, 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 smile. And voila, deep-fried human spirit. Faking It, Burger Man to Chef, tonight at 9 on 4.
Amanda's in the shadow of Mount Olympus in 45 minutes for a place in the sun, and at 5.25 swapping Nottingham for Calgary in Canada, and vice versa, for a while anyway, in Home From Home. That's all to come after Countdown.
I'll take bread, gouda, milk and all grain.
And what can you make with that?
When you want lettuce, go ahead and go to Gooding.